Now a WGN Investigates exclusive, kids in crisis forced to sleep on the floor of a state office building. A new federal court filing says it happened this month, and the consequences proved especially dangerous for one of the kids. 2 weeks ago, two teenagers were left with no choice but to sleep on the floor of this Illinois Department of Children and Family Services office building in the South Loop. That's according to this letter written by the Cook County Public Guardian to a federal judge overseeing a consent decree. "Our worst fears have been realized," wrote Public Guardian Charles Goldberg. DCFS has to resort to forcing children to sleep on the hard, cold floors of its offices because it doesn't even have an adequate number of shelter beds.
It's a violation of the children's civil rights. It's a violation of their rights under a federal consent decree that governs DCFS. And it's a violation of basic human dignity for the children.
Goldberg says the kids were 16 and 17 years old. After spending the night on the floor, he said one of them ran away from DCFS and at last word had not been found. And this may not be an isolated incident. The public guardian told the judge, "I suspect other children have also suffered the same indignity in recent weeks."
Are you surprised to hear kids are sleeping on the floors of DCFS offices?
Unfortunately, I'm not.
Ben Wolf is an attorney for the American Civil Liberties Union, which fought for and received a federal consent decree in the mid-1990s governing the treatment of kids in DCFS custody. The case grew out of a strikingly similar situation in which the state agency charged with protecting kids was forcing some of them to sleep on office floors.
And there may not be hundreds of kids yet sleeping in offices. I think there aren't, or we would know it. But the fact that you have a few is a symptom of a growing cancer, and you have to address it.
A DCFS spokesperson tells WGN Investigates the agency is aware of the concerns raised in the public guardian's letter. While not addressing specific questions, DCFS released a statement that reads, "Under the new administration, long-standing challenges within DCFS are being addressed. The department is committed to rebuilding the child welfare system in Illinois and strengthening programs and services that keep children and youth safe." The ACLU says kids sleeping on the floor is not only a symptom of not enough emergency shelter beds, but it also underscores problems throughout the entire system.
Illinois keeps kids in substitute care, foster homes and institutions, away from permanent families longer than any other state in the country. And so it keeps backing up and it keeps being stuck.
The Cook County Public Guardian says the shelter bed shortage is now so routine an office conference room has converted it into a makeshift shelter. DCFS has not confirmed that, but admits that a shelter shortage is a problem. As that federal consent decree illustrates, it's not a new one. The ACLU is now asking a federal judge to force the agency to find appropriate care for every kid in crisis. And this is just the beginning of an up-close and in-depth look at the agency. WGN will spend an entire week reporting on the challenges facing DCFS and what the children most in need are facing. Look for our reports, Protecting Children, Examining DCFS, beginning Monday, July 8th, right here on WGN News.